A Gift of Attu. The Tongan Legend of the Skipjak Tuna. Written by Amy Hemsote. Years ago, the daughter of a Samoan chief was known far and wide for her beauty. Her name was Hina of Alipata, in Upolu, Samoa. The eldest son of the Tuyi Tonga, King of Tonga, named Nana Ikimemua, or just Iki, heard of her beauty and decided to sail from Tongatapu to Samoa. On his way, he picked up his youngest brother Nanatatafu, the chief of Haano, in the Hapai Island group. When Iki arrived in Samoa, he asked his brother to guard the boat instead of attending the feast, fearing that Nanatatafu's good looks would distract Hina. Nanatatafu said to his eldest brother, "As you wish." Hina asked her attendant to retrieve some water, in order to make raw fish, skipjak tuna, for her guests. When the attendant went to the beach, she saw the beautiful Nanatatafu, and became distracted. Annoyed, Hina sent a second attendant to find out what had happened to the first. She too saw the handsome boy. When they returned, Hina was still angry, and ordered the first maid to be punished. The maid explained that she was distracted by the beautiful boy on the beach, Nanatatafu. Intrigued, she gave the attendant her scented oil to give to Nanatatafu, so that later that night he would be able to find her in the dark. When they met at last, they talked all night, and they fell in love. That night Hina offered her fish, the skipjak tuna, to Nanatatafu. She told him that it was a gift to remember her by. The next day, the Tongans left Samoa. Iki was very upset with his younger brother. When near the island of Mohunga 1, Iki stood up and told his brother and his Fijian attendant to swim to Haano, which was 12 miles away. They both jumped in and started swimming to the island, followed by Hina's skipjak tuna, while Iki returned home to Tongatapu. Finally, Nanatatafu made it to the inner reef of Haano. He stood up waiting for his Fijian servant. Just as the servant made it to the reef, he died. Today this part of the reef is still named after him, called Mahukuo Mate, which means, made it but already dead. Though sad, Nanatatafu had made it home with Hina's fish. Every year it is said that Hina's fish return to Haano as an annual love gift from Samoa. Before Nanatatafu left Samoa, Hina gave him specific instructions with regards to the fish. The fish known as skipjak or attu are only caught using a specific method of fishing known as ta'atu. Traditionally, when employing this method of fishing, many people would enter the water with an o, which is a rope with palm fronds dangling off of it that acted like a shield. The people would herd the skipjak tuna closer and closer to shore. Today, they use a net called a kupanga. Additionally, the instructions of the ritual say that the fish are not allowed to be speared or harmed in any way. They are also not able to be sold. The fish are only meant for the people living on the island, the chief, high officials in Tonga, and the king. The king is sent the skipjak tuna that jump on the beach. The chief and other dignities also get a portion of the fish, however, the people of Haano get the majority of the fish. If any of these rules are broken, then the ATU will not return the following year. This Tongan legend has been passed down for generation to generation, explaining why skipjak tuna arrive in their waters every year, and how they should harvest them. Even today, the villagers of Haano still practice the specific instructions given from Hina to ensure that the attu return every year.